Hello friends, welcome to the lecture series of subject Special Purpose Vehicle. Myself Professor Lau Patel from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology, Automobile Engineering Department. So we are in continue with chapter 4 that is based on tractors. We have studied different points or topics related to tractors. So this is our last lecture for that particular chapter, in which we will talk about hydraulic control system, like how hydraulic system can actually affect my overall attachment of the tractor. The second point, that is the 3-point hitch system. Again, these kind of system that has been worked with the help of such hydraulics, and this can be used in attachment or mountings or any kind of accessories. The third point, that is the PTO shaft, or we can say the power takeoff unit. Again, the power from the tractor that can be utilized for specific purpose, that we will see in our third topic, that is power takeoff unit. So let us begin with the first topic, that is hydraulic control system. So it is a mechanism in tractor to raise, hold or lower of mounted or semi-mounted equipment by hydraulic means. We all know several tasks that we have to do with the help of tractors. So for that we are using such kind of hydraulic system. So for that we need such system, so it can affect my overall accessories to raise, to lower or to hold several equipment. So for that the working principle, we are using Pascal's law. It can state that the pressure applied to enclosed fluid in transmitted equally in all directions. So here you will find in figure, like surface area of piston is there, in which the fluid is there. If I am applying such pressure with the help of lever, what will happen? The other part, the other portion of ram or surface area, that can be deflected with the help of this lever. So the small force acting on the small area can produce higher force on a surface or a larger area. So based on this principle, we are using such hydraulic system. So in our hydraulic system, we are using different kind of components. So the basic components are hydraulic pump. So based on that, we are transporting our oil from one compartment, one component to another one. Second, hydraulic cylinder and piston. Then the hydraulic tank or storage tank, at which we are placing our oil into it. Next, the control valve, safety valve, hose pipe and fittings, and last one, that is the fittings arm. So these are the basic components that we are using for overall hydraulic system. So now what about operation? So for operation, we can say that the hydraulic pumps that transport my oil from oil reservoir to control valves. So from the pump, my oil goes to the control valve with the very high pressure. Now from the control valve, the oil goes to the hydraulic cylinder, and from that cylinder we are operating pistons and cylinder, and which raises the lifting arm. So the at the end of the piston we are attaching lifting arms. So with the help of lifting arms we are operating such task, or like attachment of accessories or mountings, and the lifting arms are attached with implements or accessories, and the hydraulic pump that is operated by suitable gears or connected with the engine. So based on this, we are using two type of arrangement of storing hydraulic oils. First, the regular or common oil reservoir for hydraulic system and transmission system. So the oil is common, whether it should be hydraulic system or transmission system. Also, for separate tank should be also provided in such kind of arrangement. So there are two types. First is the common oil reservoir, and the second one, that is the special tank that is provided for specifically hydraulic purpose. Next, this is the overall schematic diagram of hydraulic system, in which you are you can see that the two gears that has been attached, we are considering it hydraulic pump. So from the filter or oil tank, we are sucking the oil with the help of hydraulic pumps and transporting it to the control valve. Now based on the control valve, or with the help of control valve, we are directing our that high pressure oil to the piston cylinder arrangement, and from that piston actuation we are actually actuating our linked arm or linking accessories or mountings. So based on these application we are choosing our hydraulic system. Now let us talk about the second topic, that is 3-point hitch system. So it is a one kind of accessory that has been attached in every tractor at the rear portion. Like if you need to attach several plow or trailers or any other links, so for that these kind of arrangement should be provided in our tractors, that is called 3-point hitch system. So for the efficient and safe tractor operation, implements, or again the another word for implements, that is called mountings or accessories, that are to be hitched properly or connected properly. So for that we are choosing 3-point hitch system. So it can be trailed, semi mounted or mounted type. So basically 3-point hitch system or linkage, that is a combination of three links. There are three links, one that is the upper link and another two links that are called lower links, the links that is articulated to the tractor and the implements at their ends in order to connect the mountings to the tractor. So for the attachment of mounting and accessories we are choosing three points. First, that is the upper link, and the two more links that are called lower links, and based on the mounting attachment we are choosing such kind of system. Now what about the advantages of 3-point linkage system or hitch system? That is easy control of working implements, quick setting of implements, automatic hydraulic control of implements such as position control, draft control, and last one, that is the good balancing of attached implements. So depending upon the accessories, whether you should connect it very hardly or without play or with play, based on that selection we are choosing our 3-point hitch system. Now this is a basic diagram in which you can see that the mast that has been attached or that has to be attached at my 3-link hitch system. In 3-link system, that can be operated with the help of hydraulic system. Again, it is here in figure, you can see that the upper link is there, that can be controlled with the help of hydraulics. So with the help of hydraulic system we are able to do upward and downward motion of my upper link. So this is my upper link, and again two bottom links here you can see that, that is called lower links. Again the lower link arrangement should be in such way that it can be, its length can be adjustable depending upon the accessories. So based on 3 points, upper link, that is first point, and two both lower links, so based on this point we can say that it is a 3-link hitch system. So here one mast has been provided. So again this portion that has been attached with my upper link, and this end, like these two ends, that has been attached at my lower hitch points. So this is only one accessories. We are choosing several accessories to connect with my 3 hitch points. Now let us see about the power takeoff unit or power or PTO shaft or PTO unit. So the tractor is used not only for pulling the implements like tiltage operation, showing of various crops, but it is also used to power stationary equipment. So the power production can be done with the help of tractor only or with the help of power takeoff shaft for doing such operations like threshing of crops, pumping water from tube wells, etc. So for that such arrangement should be provided, and that power outlet, that is called my power takeoff shaft or PTO shaft. Now the PTO has been provided on tractor for quite some time. Like in India, PTO shaft is usually at its rear side, but in developed countries a front PTO shaft that has been also there. Simply from the output of the shaft after my differential, you need to control such RPM, like depending upon the application, if you need 500 RPM or 1000 RPM. So in case of 540 RPM, the shaft has 6 splines that can be attached with my PTO shaft, while for 1000 RPM shaft the number of splines are 21. So based on the RPM we are choosing splines. Now if you are talking about spline, this is my shaft in which you will see the different splines, number of splines. So the first figure which states that there are 6 splines are there. Also from the second figure you will find there are 21 splines which has been placed. So depending upon the RPM and grip we are choosing our splines. Now based on this video you will actually know about the power takeoff shaft, like how it can be worked. So in the video you can see that one attached trailer should be there, and this is my output shaft. First you need to switch off the tractor output, then depending upon the accessories or attachments you need to adjust several mountings with tractor. So here you can lower the jack stand, rotate it up and secure it. So several jack has been provided. So at the end you will find the length should be adjustable for power takeoff shaft. So now here in the video you can see that it can be attached, like the shaft that has been extract or extend, and the splines that has been engaged with my power takeoff shaft. Here you will find several splines. First you need to make sure that splines and notches that has been easily fixed with each other, so it cannot move from its place. Now make sure it is engaged, and based on that you can transfer these power to do such kind of work. So that is all for today's lecture. Thank you.